Oh, that's loud.
Let's just. Well, we better start, otherwise we'll never start.
No.
Okay.
Find some space, that's great. So just have your feet shoulder width apart, lengthen up through your spine. So I've got a couple of weeks off, a couple of Mondays off. Wednesdays will be running as normal. And because we've got the bank holiday, and then the week after I'm doing my Tai Chi rehabilitation training in Birmingham, so I'll be away. But just have the feet shoulder width apart, lengthen up through the spine. Relax around the jaw. And then just turn and myself, and if you put it on those of you on Zoom, if you put it on speaker view and pin me, that should hopefully work. If not, I've got no idea why I don't understand Zoom very well. So we're just doing this. We're going to go through all the loosening exercises. And we're all breathing. So just let go around the jaw, just let your muscles relax.
Were you in the classroom?
Yeah, I was, well, not, I mean, I had a bit of a sore throat and runny nose, but I felt fine, but obviously, because I was testing positive, and the NHS says, don't go anywhere and spread your germs around. I stayed put because I, you know. But it just basically meant I was twiddling my thumbs most of the week. And I taught all my Zoom classes. That was fun because you can't
yeah.
spread germs on Zoom. So at least not yet.
Well, when you
so.
Twiddle on your thumbs, I suppose you've got a special way of doing it.
Yeah, the Tai Chi way of twiddling my thumbs. Yeah,
yeah,
we've done
the
Zoom. Yeah. But I tested negative over the weekend. I thought, brilliant, right, let me out there. So I think I've got to take another week off where I work for the at the care place, which is understandable because
yeah.
you know I might, although I'm not registering as and the tests, I've done two tests, but they've got to be super careful, so. So keep going. Sink your hips, breathe, relax around the jaw. I'll show you that from the side. So you're looking forwards, you're listening behind and above.
Yeah, I twiddled my thumbs mindfully. Hang on, let's just check. Oh, I don't need that one on, and I don't need that one on. Right, that should be better.
And hopefully, yeah. So we just bounce. We'll do bounce. So just let the arms relax. Bring your chin in. Lengthen through the spine. And we're all breathing. Very good. Bounce and shake. And bounce. Very good.
Weird things to your breathing, yeah.
I'm still trying to get into the, because when Emma does it, she'll do it for like 5 to 10 minutes. And it's quite, you really feel like you've used your muscle. Bounce is actually a lot easier, but it shakes a bit. You just think, oh. Okay, and then we'll just do this one. So just really let the arms relax. Keep breathing short. Very nice. And we're using our legs. It's Sharon, isn't it? Sharon on Friday.
Sharon
with a Y. With a Y. Sharon on the Friday. Yeah. How's she getting on? Is she having fun? I shoot. Brilliant. Good for her. That's good. No, I think the more Tai Chi, very good. Turn the palms up. Now that particular school, actually it's a UK-wide school, but they only ever have volunteer instructors. They don't have, they train them all up and all that, but they don't, they're not allowed to have a wage. So you'll get them teaching maybe one or two classes a week. That's nice. Well, it's no different than like if someone runs a choir or something. They you know, and then you get people that get paid to sing, so you know, it's fine.
Nobody paid you to sing.
No. Inside the bin. Did you ever see him?
No.
He'd had a guitar, you'd see the arms and the guitar in that bin. See? Weird. No, my friend Banjo Nick, who's sometimes busting Cambridge, he's around in London area at the moment. He was in Dartford, yeah, where the tunnel is. And four, three, two, one, and change. And I've not seen the tightrope fiddle playing man either. There was a guy who set up a tightrope between a couple of trees near Waitrose, and he'd busk and play. His fiddle playing wasn't that great, but it's difficult enough playing already with that. Oh, Snowy Far, yeah, with all the animals, yeah. I didn't like his statue, but they did. Have you seen his statue outside? It doesn't look nothing like him. You just think, that's supposed to be Snowy. That looks really scary. It looks like something like Doctor Who. If they'd have done an actual statue of him that looked like him, or picture, it's just too surreal, really. Just... Yeah, I saw him a couple of times. It's a funny town, isn't it, Cambridge? You don't... So we just... Maybe you had your COVID yet, or not yet?
No.
No? Oh, just getting...
We don't test
I say.
Relax the shoulders a bit more, everybody. That's better. And we're moving on, moving the weight, and just feeling it in your legs. Four, three, two, and one. Mars. Okay. Posture check. Oh, so you've got this lovely long feeling in the spine. You're sinking your hips. You're breathing. And we're doing this. So relax around the palms of the hands. Just let the palms of the hands feel bigger. Nick, the guy that does the wildlife stuff, he's done a reading of something that was written about owls in 1700 and something, and we put the music to it, and it's awesome. It's really cool. Can you download? Do you know how to do that? If I send you something?
I don't, but my daughter does.
Excellent. All right, I'll email you the thing.
Yeah.
The thing that I got from Nick.
Oh, yeah.
And then you can listen to the thing about the owls that was written in 1700, because it's just amazing. I'm on piano, fiddle and cello, I think, and he's on the wind harp, guitar and handpan and stuff. Also the vocals, he does it, it's really nice narration. Yeah, if you're interested, send us an email and I'll send you this thing about owls. And eventually it will be released as a thing that you pay for, but I just thought I'm looking for feedback. So I'm quite pleased. It's great. Okay, four, three, two, and one. Okay, and this one, just turn it. So this one, I've only been doing about 16 years and I still can't quite get it, but hopefully seeing Karen in a couple of weeks' time. Oh. So he's teaching on the 14th of May, so I'm hopefully going to see him then. Yeah, this is Peter on the piano now. and just lengthen by floating up your head and then sinking your hips back and down. And you want to be square on to where you're pointing to. So if you're on Zoom, you'll be square onto your screen. Hang on, let me just move this. You'll be square onto your screen. If you're in the room, you'll be square onto the opposite wall. And then what we're going to do, we're going to sink forward and sink back. I almost wore my shorts this morning and I thought, no. So you can't see, but my knees are in line with the toes. Normally when I do my Zoom sessions or any sessions, I try and wear shorts as much as possible because then you can see where the knees are in relation to the toes and this, but it's just a little bit character building on the part of. I wore shorts at the weekend and then, well, on Saturday and then on Sunday I was like, ooh, that's horrible. So I thought, well, something small, very nice. Brilliant. And then forwards and back, and just let the arms swing forwards and back. So it's like loosening exercise number two, but with the, like that, there you go. I'll show you from the diagonal view. So it's like this. So you want to try and keep your feet flat on the floor if you can. There are versions where you don't. This is just the version where you keep your feet flat on the floor. And you're feeling the natural springs in each foot. The natural springs in each foot, that's it. And we're all breathing. Now try that with the other leg forward. So we're doing the two turns per leg, and then we're doing the forwards and back. So these ones I've mainly done with Mike, the head honcho of the school. So we're off to a Tai Chi retreat this weekend. So hopefully if I find something useful that I can pass on from next week, I will of course do that. It's quite good. And then forwards and back. Okay, and then we'll do Barry's one as well, so that's just great. Four, three, two, and one. Shake. Okay, so just check your posture. Lengthen through the spine. Breathing in and out. Before we move on to Barry's one, any questions so far? That also includes people on Zoom, of course. Any questions? No questions in the room. I'll just check. Anyone got any questions?
Or any requests or anything? Yeah. Excellent. Yeah, I'll send you some. What is the meaning of life? No idea.
Have fun, I think. Practice Tai Chi. There you go. Yes, I'll send you the stuff about Overstrand. I've made a mental note, and I'll send. Yeah, because it will be good. But I've got to wait. Peter's got to send it to me first because he's in charge because he lives around there, and then he'll tell me what's going on, and then I'll tell everyone else. I just know I'm part of it, so yeah. So Barry's exercise. So we start from the middle. We go 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4. There will be cake. There's usually cake. 5. That's really important to know. 6, 7. Our poster normally has the word cake in it every time I've done anything.
You can include ice cream as well.
Sorry?
There's an online game called Portal.
Oh, right.
But the slogan is, the cake is a lie.
Oh! The cake is?
It's a lie.
It's a lie. Here we go. We'll do this one. So you turn, and then, turn. It's a bit like that when I was... The roads from when you go through the sort of back way here from London, they're really terrible. There were like bits at the end that weren't there, that it was all jagged, and I was thinking, hang on a minute, what am I paying all this tax for? So like this, so you turn, and then, that's it, turn. So it's good for your spine, this one, and also good if you're having one of those days, you can just go, oh, brilliant. I'm more time each side. Nice. Okay, next. He just does a big one and a little one in the middle. So this is stage three. Big, little. Big, show that from the side, little. Big.
Oh.
two and see how we're getting on with that. Ready? And begin. So, yeah, hopefully in a couple of weeks I'll have learned the second set. Going on now. We've got the 18 set, we've got the Shibashi set part 1, which is what we're doing, and then part 2 to come. And then we've got the Yang style Tai Chi Qigong set, and we've also got the Badawan Jin, so which is great. And also Swimming Smiling Dragon, which I haven't attempted with anyone yet, because I'm still waiting for. Yeah, Swimming and Smiling Dragon is wonderful, but I'd have to get that checked out by my teacher before I'm allowed to teach it, so I'm just practicing it myself. Okay, now change to number 2. So movement 2, open the chest. Nice and tall. So you want the arms to just float. Just float your arms, that's it. Feel a solid connection to the ground. So it's a good one for the neck as well as you're turning your head. One more time each side, very good. And then just relax, just let the arms float down. Check your posture momentarily and then off we go, part the clouds. One more time, that's great. Rolling arms. Then one more time each side. And fashionable up in front of the shoulder. Here we go. Spines. Check your posture as much as you can. Okay, we'll do one more time each side. That's lovely, everybody. Really nice. And then cow gazes at moon. I really like this move. I just love the name of the move, cow gazes at the moon. This thing, that's just really nice. Because you get dragons, you get phoenixes, and you get cows. I think that's nice. So next time we're in a field of cows and there's a moon, you know what to do.
Do you think
they'll
join in?
I think they might join in. If you did it, they might join in. And then one more time each side. Marvellous. And then come back. Fantastic. So sink your hips. Nice and relaxed. And then so like when you're refusing an Easter egg, you know. Breathing some more, very good. One more time each side. Marvellous, okay. Scooping the sea, looking up at the sky. And then one more time on this side. Lovely. And then we'll change sides. You just want to take more time to get your feet in the right spots first. And then off we go. We're all breathing. So this is the version that the professor devised where you get a bit of an ankle workout as well. And it's different than other versions I've done, which are all equally valid. One more time. Fantastic. Change sides. And one more time. Good. Yeah. Okay, change sides again. And we'll do a flying pigeon. So we just come back, raise up, come forward. Two more. One more. Nice. Change sides. And begin. And then one more time each arm. Nice. Relax the shoulders, relax the arms. Just get your hips nicely sunk, lengthen through the spine, and then off we go, wild goose flies. And time. Beautiful, everybody. That's great. Going to go to tall bout on a slightly kind of not too enthusiastic horse dogs. So, and then off we go, rotating like a flying wheel. Off we go. That's lovely. So imagine a great big wheel turning. And then do one more rotation in this direction. And then when you get to the bottom corner, change direction. Marching. Here we go. One, two. something. And we do one more.
They might think we've got mad cow's disease, yeah.
That's brilliant. Yeah, I think we've got that. I mean, the tricky bits, that bit seemed to be okay.
Yeah.
And then that bit seemed to be fine this week as well. So let's sort of not... Let's move on. Okay, I think last week we had to go at those, didn't we?
Yeah.
We were looking at walking and balancing. Any requests or?
Yeah, that's true. It is midday.
Well, it will be the moon somewhere on the earth, you know. Especially some people on. I mean, I was on Zoom the other day at a music thing. And apparently it was like 3 o'clock in the morning in Japan. There was a couple of people from Japan over. And they just went to bed early and got up so they could come to this thing at 3 a.m. their time. So, you know, they'd have been looking at a moon. So, anyway, let's do something that doesn't require too much in terms of balance. Let's do my take off as fruit. And we just do that, and then we go like that, and we go like that. Go like that. Okay, and it's very simple. Mars, let's go. Should we start this end? Yeah, you can walk this time. We're just gonna go for a little walk and then we'll all lie down.
Yeah.
Overtone singing, and the only reason why he was there is he was his farmer in the Netherlands, and he sings to his cows every morning, and he wanted to sing to his cows better by seeing how they got on. Apparently they love overtone chanting, so you know, I'm sure cows would love to do Tai Chi if they like people singing at them. So here we go, and we step. So this is white ape office fruit, not white cow office fruit. But we just go like this, and we come forwards, and we come back. So you want to feel really solidly connected to the ground. There we go. And we're all breathing. Very nice. So really feel the ground under your feet. just kind of does itself, really. It just sort of does itself, and then you just, it's almost like you're just watching this stuff happen. And yeah, it's just knowing and noticing what you're sensing. You want to notice what you're sensing. So if we do it the non-walking way, so just grab a ball, and we step, and then we part the wild horse's mane. You're just doing it like this. And then you feel that, and you've got the weight in the front foot. Now you open, feel that stretch, and then release the stretch, and then you sink back, and then there's another stretch, and then you release that stretch, and then you gather the ball, and then you do it on the other side. So you can even do it without needing to do much of the, you know. Say you're in a, I know, you might be on a train platform, there's not much room. You can just do it like this. And then, yeah, let's do one more time each side. We're all breathing. We're sinking, breathing. Breathing some more, marvellous. There you go. So it's like, it's quite nice to do something that's just like one movement over and over again. Because we've done the 18, and that was 18 movements. And it starts to do one thing for ages. It's nice to get the balance, you know? Okay. Now this time when you go up, we're going to do plum blossom, falls left and right, just because it's nice. It's a nice way of finishing. I quite like doing this one as a sort of finishing off movement, because it's very simple, and you also, as well as feeling great, you're still practicing more balance and stability, because we're moving our weight from one foot to the other, which is good for developing your ability to be balanced and centered. So that's all good. All breathing, fantastic. And one more time. Great. Okay. Embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. Nice and relaxed. Keep breathing. Very good. So feel that your whole body is connected. Yeah. Top and then see if it works this morning. Rub the hands together and polishing the face. Fantastic. And rub the hands together again and give your lower back a rub. Great. Okay, relax the shoulders. Just breathe in and out. Just check your posture. So really feel that you've got a good connection, a solid connection with your feet in the ground. And we're just doing this. Breathing in. why we should stop. Okay, one more time. Very good. Nice and tall. And make a fist with the right hand, left hand over the top. Bring your feet together and bow. Brilliant. Well done, us. That was wonderful. Fantastic. Well done, Zoomies. Well done, Roomies. Great. Let's go and lie down. Excellent.
Great. Good job.